Greetings. Thank you all for coming back to the Spirit Walker channel. I really appreciate your support, your views, your comments. And today we're going to talk about alien encounters, Orion, Confederation, or others. Yes, it's not really adequate to pigeonhole anyone, and pigeonhole non-terrestrial beings is necessarily going to be limiting and maybe even wrong. But you know, for simplicity, let's just name these three groups: Orion, which is service to self, so the negative interstellar assembly of non-terrestrials; the Confederation, which is the opposite, which is service to others, and it's the beings that are trying to transform Earth into a better place and transform the universe as a whole into a better place, because they know that we are all connected. We know that we are all part of the same Creator. And of course, there are groups that are not affiliated. So these groups are, I don't know, they're traitors, they are adventurers, they are the groups that could be in just learning expeditions, like scientific expeditions, in the same way that, I don't know, David Attenborough goes to Africa to film monkeys. We also have non-terrestrial groups, they're trying to study us and trying to understand how is it that we could have a planet that is so violent, and how could we even exist in such a planet. They could also be breakaway groups, so people that, or groups that were originally affiliated with Orion, and they broke away because they disagree with the way that Orion is conducting their agenda. Or could be groups that were associated with the Confederation and broke away because they decided to, I don't know, to polarize slightly more negatively. They wanted to, I don't know, make or create wealth or something like this. So you also have breakaway groups. But the first thing that I wanted to discuss here is the nature of the contact. We have this view that an alien encounter would necessarily be, you know, a flying saucer landing on your backyard and taking you away with them. And that's one type of encounter. That's that one type of contact. But we also have other types of contacts. You have to remember that these beings, they are usually fourth density and sometimes even a fifth density. So they are highly telepathic. They know, you know, telekinesis. They can astral project very easily. All of these things that we are, as humans, we are trying to learn now. These guys, the fourth density and fifth density, they do this with a snap of a finger. It's really their bread and butter. So you could have an alien encounter that comes to you in the form of a dream, or an intuition, or a synchronicity. A synchronicity, I think you would have to be maybe a higher level being, such as a sixth density being, to actually change the physical environment around you, just so you could have that synchronicity or that piece of information in exactly the time and the circumstances that you need it. But it's possible. It's possible to happen. You could also have things like astral encounters. So when you go to sleep and you detach from your physical body, you could meet ETs. You could meet non-terrestrial beings, and they would be in there. Astral form as well. There have been some psychic descriptions of beings that come around to the solar system, and then they park their craft somewhere around the solar system. They don't approach Earth with their craft, but they park somewhere around the solar system. And they, from there, then they astral project and they come to Earth in their astral form. And that is a far safer way for them to come and visit us and study us than if they actually came here to with their craft, because we know that the Illuminati Cabal and the reptilians, they shoot people down, then they're trying to start a war pretty much. And if they can't start a real war with an alien group, they will fake one. But that's what they're doing, and sometimes an astral encounter is going to be far safer for the non-terrestrial being than any other form of contact. So I just wanted to make this summary that an alien encounter is not really what we saw on that movie E.T., you know, decades ago. It could take many shapes and forms. Maybe you have been contacted. You're watching this video now. You have been contacted. Maybe even several nights or several days, or maybe you have been contacted on a daily basis or on a nightly basis, and you don't realize. These things could come in dreams, synchronicities, intuitions, and actual astral visitations. So if we could start with the Orion group, as we discuss, these guys are the negative guys. They're mostly reptilians and greys, and apparently some insectoids as well. But there are basically five types of contacts, or five types of targets that they are after. Four types of contacts that they are after. But before we go there, I just wanted to make sure that the Orion group, they don't respect free will. They will abduct, kidnap anyone that they feel like, and they can force a contact with people that want to have a contact with them, or with people that don't want to have a contact with them. They have no qualms in breaking the law of free will, and this is why they eventually are going to incur a crap load of karma, because they don't respect these basic universal laws. So the first type of human that are contacted by Orion are the weak-minded. So these are the people that live a material life. They just want to make money. They just want to live their lives without any really consideration. They're usually either young souls or mature souls. They just want, they're just living for the material. They just want, you know, money and sex and food and you know, booze, and basically. That's their life. That's how they live their life. Now these guys are easy prey for Orion, because Orion comes around and promises them the whole world, and many of them will say yes. And then when you sign that contract, so to speak, then you are in big trouble, because Orion will give you some of the things that you requested, but then they will come back at some stage to get their part of the deal, and then you're going to be in big shit. That's pretty much it. The second type of contactees are those that have already decided to be negative. So these are the elite. So this is the Illuminati Cabal, and the Illuminati Cabal, those that have already made a decision to be negative, they will seek contact with Orion, and they will try to control Orion, and Orion will try to control them. So it's basically, it's like a den of snakes, you know, each one trying to bite and poison the other one, and there is no harmony, and there is just this big mess that they try to make with the selfish souls entering into contact with even more selfish souls. So that is one of the types of contact. So when Orion contacts the elite, the name that we give this here on the planet is basically satanic rituals. So when the elite contacting the entities of Orion, the way that we usually describe this is as satanic rituals. Now there is another type of group of contactees, and they are the indebted souls. So basically, these are the people that agreed and cooperated with Orion in the past. So they did satanic. They had satanic agreements with entities, even if they thought that these entities were spiritual entities, but they didn't know what was really happening. But then at some stage they decided that they did not want to be positive, they did not want to be negative anymore, so they decided to go back and retrace their path and go back to a positive path. Expunging their own karma and trying to do good to others. But as I said, when you sign a contract with the devil, you are in big shit, because Orion will chase you. A lot of the contactees that are being harassed by non-terrestrial entities are in this category. So if you're curious, just look at videos on YouTube on, for example, super soldiers and all of the people that are born into secret military programs and mind control programs, and they are. Although they are positive, these victims are positive. They must have done something to be born on that situation in the first place. If you watch the videos of Sarah Stanger, so it's a British woman that has been in all of these mind control programs, you will see that, you know, she's desperately trying to do the right thing. But Orion keeps coming back at her, and this is it. And it's actually very sad. It's a very sad situation. So look up Sarah Stanger, and you will understand that when you sign a contract with the negatives, it's very, very hard to get out when you decide to. And the fourth group that is visited or attacked by Orion is the group of people that are trying to do something to improve mankind. So people that are trying to do, that actively improve mankind in some way. So you will find that if you make a decision to be a positive person and try to develop love in your heart, very often you will start getting attacked at work, humiliated at work, or maybe a partner will leave you, or maybe people will, you know, they'll have flashes of road rage against you on the streets, or all of that stuff. All of these things are Orion trying to dissuade you from making that positive contribution to mankind. But these contacts are actually relatively rare, because they are dangerous for Orion. Because when people do make a decision to go positive, the more that Orion contact such people, the riskier it is for Orion, because they can end up depolarizing. I remember that in a spiritual session one day, it happened back in Brazil. A medium was astrally connected to a negative being, and the negative being was brought to this medium just so they would talk to someone else, and in this case that other person was me. And as we started talking, it turns out that I started asking about that negative entity, why he or she was so angry, and that I was a friendly person and I wanted to hear what that negative entity had to say. I was not there to hurt that being, and that I did not understand why that being was sent to hurt people or to incorporate into a medium. And that being had no reason to be fearful, and I just wanted to be friends and understand where that hatred was coming from. So just by saying that, you could see that the negative being was losing their power, was losing their polarity, their negative polarity. So they started saying things that didn't really quite make sense, and then someone else came along and took that being away from the medium, because they had lost their effectiveness, because they realized that they were not going to scare anyone in that meeting, and they were actually running a very great risk of depolarizing. As I just started asking that person, or that spirit, what was wrong, and if I could help in any way. So it is difficult, it is very dangerous for Orion to contact someone that has already decided on a positive path. And this is probably the case of all of you here watching this video. Orion will most likely not contact you because they know that there is a danger that they will end up depolarizing as they get in touch with the love that is in your heart. Okay, now the Confederation, that's the other group. The Confederation is, as I said, well, just in very broad terms, these are the good guys. They do respect your free will. And it's interesting that the Law of One says that the Confederation beings only appear to wanderers. They only appear to the brothers, the so-called brothers and sisters of sorrow. So these are some human beings. They are here in third density, but they are actually they come from a higher density somewhere, and they were sent here to help the planet change or raise its vibration. These are the wanderers. The Law of One says that the Confederation only talks to wanderers, and it's very, very rare to be in a physical form. The Confederation will most likely approach you, not in a physical form, but they will approach you in terms of synchronicities, intuition, messages in dreams. And because of that, it's very unlikely that if you see lights in the sky, it's very unlikely that they will be Confederation. Chances are that they are either neutral or Orion. Now, they could be called. You may be able to call Confederation beings, or you may be able to call Confederation ships. It's unlikely that they would show up, because higher beings, they have a lot of work. They're serious, and they have a lot of work to do on this planet. They are not going to show up just because of party tricks, because you want to show your friends that you're cool. It's not going to happen. They will only show up if there is a very serious job to be done. So this is why contact with the Confederation is extremely rare, or should I say, direct physical contact with Confederation is extremely rare. In most cases, it's more in terms of intuition, synchronicities, messages, and things like that. Because what happens is, if they contact someone that has not asked for that contact or is not ready for that contact, then what happens is that they, the Confederation, will incur karma for infringing the free will of that person. And Orion doesn't care for that, because Orion is already full of karma anyway, so they don't give a shit. But the Confederation does, and they don't want to do that. They don't want to infringe on your freedom of will. And this is why I say that some of the things like, not every instance, but in some instances, you know, things like lights in the sky, crop circles, they might very well be from the Confederation, from the good guys, because they do respect the free will of people. You see the first, if you see a light in the sky, the first thing that you will hear is someone that doesn't want to believe. They will say, "Well, that's just a flare." So that is that person using his or her free will to deny something that they have seen, and they are scared. They don't want to go deeper into that, so they make up that excuse that it's just a flare. Crop circles as well. There's quite a lot of people out there saying that all crop circles are human-made. So these are people that are using their free will to basically deny something that they know deep inside. They know that it's coming from another level. So for this reason, these means of communication, they do respect the free will of others, because some people will believe. Those that are ready will believe, and those that are not ready will just make up some lame excuse, such as, "Oh, that's just it's a weather balloon," and then they'll go home and they will do whatever it is that they want to do. So their free will is not infringed. And the last group is the unaffiliated, or, you know, the breakaway civilizations, or the breakaway groups, the learning expeditions. And then so they can contact us for a range of reasons, as some reasons similar to Orion, some reasons more similar to the Confederation. But the important thing is, if you do feel that you're being contacted, just raise your vibration. Imagine yourself in a ball of purple light and purple energy, because low vibration entities, they can't stand the high vibration of the purple energy and the purple ray. So imagine your life, your body, and your astral body surrounded by that light. Raise your vibration, say a prayer, and in most cases, if the entity is negative, they'll just not tolerate that that situation, and they'll move away. How do you know that you have been contacted by Orion? When you feel that after the contact, you feel a sense of violation. You have been violated, or you feel a sense of infringement, and it's that nasty aftertaste that you have when you met someone that isn't really quite right. How do you know that it was a Confederation contact? If that contact leaves you with a sense of love, a sense of peace, and a sense of harmony, and if that contact creates the desire in you to get to know yourself better and to develop into more service to others, helping others. So if that's the case, if that's how you felt after being contacted, that was most likely a contact from a Confederation being or a Confederation group. And you are really very blessed. So thank you for your for your attention. If you like this video, please like, subscribe and share, and see you next time.